Encuentren súper bien el día de hoy. Bueno, primero que nada, mucho gusto. Mi nombre es Angélica Franco y los saludo desde la Educación Internacional. Bueno, el día de hoy estaremos entonces con Olivier Charpentier. Él nos estará acompañando directamente desde University of Western Australia. La idea es que el día de hoy podamos resolver todas las dudas que ustedes puedan llegar a tener. Él nos estará hablando pues un poquito acerca de las facultades de la universidad como tal. Y bueno, antes de iniciar con su presentación, yo quisiera pues que conocieran un poco más de la agencia. Nuevamente agradecerles a todos los que se están conectando. Bienvenidos. Les quería comentar un poquito acerca de quiénes somos nosotros. Nosotros en este momento somos la agencia más grande de Latinoamérica. Ya contamos con 20 años, más de 20 años de experiencia y tenemos presencia física o remota en todos los países de Latinoamérica. Así que si tú estás, por ejemplo, en Lima, en Perú, bueno, allá tenemos oficina. Si estás en Medellín, en Colombia, también tenemos oficina. Así que, bueno, tenemos oficina en diferentes partes del mundo y la ventaja es que también tenemos una oficina en Perth, la ciudad donde se encuentra pues la universidad. Así que incluso cuando tú llegues a Australia, vas a seguir contando con nuestro acompañamiento, con nuestra asesoría. ¿Cuáles son nuestros servicios? Básicamente es que tenemos, te vamos a dar como información sobre, en este caso, pues sobre la universidad, sobre los programas. Tenemos un servicio de asesoría personalizada. Te asesoramos durante todas las etapas del proceso. ¿Qué implica esto? Bueno, mira, revisamos tu perfil. Este programa aplicaría para ti. Revisamos también opciones de ciudades, opciones de programas, de instituciones. Evaluamos los costos, las etapas del proceso, qué documentos vas a requerir. Te apoyamos en tu proceso de visado, en este caso que aplicaría una visa de estudiante, certificación y traducción de documentos, información sobre las becas o cuáles opciones de financiamiento pues vas a tener disponibles y cómo es el proceso entonces de obtener seguro médico, cuáles aseguradoras pues son reconocidas por el gobierno australiano, bueno, como una serie de asesoría que va desde que el momento que tú nos contactas, nos cuentas acerca de quién eres tú, qué quieres, cuáles son tus objetivos, hasta el momento en que decides, bueno, ya compré mis tiquetes, voy a estar en este caso en Perth, por ejemplo, en el 2023. Nosotros, además de Australia, igual el día de hoy vamos a hablar pues un poquito acerca de Australia, en este caso pues de Perth, de la universidad como tal. Tenemos otros destinos como Canadá, España, Estados Unidos, Irlanda, Malta, Nueva Zelanda, Reino Unido. Así que en caso tal de que tú estés de pronto interesado, tengas un familiar, un amigo, un conocido que esté interesado en otros destinos, bueno, los invitamos de igual manera a que sigan conectados a través de nuestras redes sociales, ya que nosotros hacemos diferentes seminarios, diferentes eventos y a través de las redes sociales, pues te vas a enterar entonces acerca de ellos. ¿Listo? Como el día de hoy vamos a enfocarnos específicamente en Australia, pues tenemos aquí la participación de University of Western Australia. La idea es entonces hablarles un poquito acerca de, bueno, cuáles son las ventajas. Australia como tal, como destino, tiene las universidades que se encuentran entre las 200 mejores del mundo. Uno de los, digamos, de los mayores beneficios que sé que muchas personas los conocemos y que por eso es que de pronto, bueno, cuando tenemos un amigo o alguien que nos habla de Australia, sabemos que puedes trabajar medio tiempo mientras estudias, tiempo completo cuando estás en vacaciones. Hay ciudades para todos los gustos, en este caso Perth, específicamente es una ciudad que está en crecimiento, es una ciudad que tiene, digamos, muy buenas oportunidades laborales precisamente por esa inversión. En este caso, de particular de Australia como tal, hay mayor probabilidad de aceptación en la institución que tú elijas en relación pues a otros países. El título profesional es aceptado sin necesidad de convalidarlo, es decir, al momento de que hagamos la aplicación a la universidad, vamos a enviar el diploma o el certificado de que efectivamente terminamos nuestra carrera universitaria y las notas. Y la ventaja es que vas a poder estar hasta 3 años adicionales trabajando a tiempo completo una vez finalices tu maestría de 2 años de duración. Un punto adicional, y por qué me gusta tanto, por qué me llama la atención y por qué me gustan estas ciudades como Perth, porque es una ciudad regional. Así que además vas a tener otro año adicional, así que en total no serían 3, sino que serían 4 años donde vas a poder estar trabajando a tiempo completo esos años adicionales. En Australia. ¿Listo? Además, Perth tiene otros beneficios. Es un destino que yo lo recomiendo particularmente, sobre todo para familias, porque los hijos de los estudiantes que vayan a maestrías, es decir, si tú estás allí y tu plan es viajar con tu pareja, con tus hijos. Bueno, la educación es gratuita para los niños que se encuentran en primaria y en secundaria. Tu pareja también va a poder trabajar, por supuesto, mientras tú estás estudiando. Entonces, son beneficios adicionales que me parecen pues ideales, porque a veces pensamos como que, bueno, voy a ir a estudiar por mi familia. La idea es que puedas viajar junto con ellos. ¿Listo? Como les mencionaba anteriormente, la idea es que sigan conectados a través de nuestras redes sociales. Aquí estamos informando constantemente sobre los eventos, sobre las ferias que nosotros hacemos. Tenemos una feria enfocada en educación superior, en Higher Education en Canadá y Australia, diferentes países. Tenemos un Supercell, que es un evento que se enfoca en cursos de inglés con unos precios promocionales. Así que si de pronto, bueno, dices, quiero empezar la maestría, pero todavía me falta como pulir el inglés, ese evento es para ti. Y estos seminarios, que son charlas precisamente enfocadas en universidades, en instituciones, en programas particulares, para que si tú ya tienes la decisión y quieres como, bueno, resolver algunas dudas, por supuesto, lo puedas hacer. ¿Listo? Como les mencionaba anteriormente, nosotros tenemos presencia física o remota en toda Latinoamérica, así que si tú nos estás viendo, no sé, desde Argentina, desde Bolivia, desde cualquier país, pues ahí estamos nosotros. Nos puedes escribir a hola@lae-almedioedu.com. La idea es que nos puedan dejar como lo más detallado sobre su perfil para nosotros poderlos orientar mejor. Bueno, ¿cuántos años tienes? ¿Qué estudiaste en la universidad? Por ejemplo, no sé, yo estudié temas relacionados con agricultura, con arquitectura, entonces nos puedas dejar saber efectivamente eso. ¿Cuándo planeas viajar? ¿Qué tipo de maestría pues te llama más la atención? Y si planeas viajar solo o sola o con familia o si tienen hijos. Entonces, para nosotros es muy importante poder entender su perfil y asimismo poderlos orientar mejor. ¿Listo? Entonces, si tienen alguna duda, al final vamos a estar resolviendo. Las pueden dejar por aquí. Vamos a estar resolviendo todas las dudas. Voy a dar paso entonces a Olivia para que nos cuente un poquito más acerca de la universidad. Recuerden que dentro de las áreas del conocimiento de esta universidad se encuentran temas relacionados con agricultura, arquitectura, negocios, educación, ingenierías. Y si, por ejemplo, en el caso de las personas que se encuentren en Colombia, pueden aplicar a Colfuturo y pues a través con la uni aplicar a la universidad, perdón, a una de las maestrías que ofrece la universidad y financiar a través de Colfuturo. De pronto también, si te encuentras en Perú, con la beca Presidente, la beca Bicentenario, podrías también ser una muy buena opción de financiación. Así que bueno, seguimos conectados. Dejen por favor todas las preguntas que puedan tener y Olivier, por favor, continúa. The presentation is all yours.
Lovely. Thank you. Thank you, Maria Angelica.
Okay, you're welcome. Now you can share your screen.
Okay, okay. Here we go. And two and sharing. Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you, Maria Angelica. I'm talking to you from Perth, where it is already Thursday morning at little after 8 o'clock. So today I will be talking about the wonderful University of Western Australia, which you can see in the background, one of the 50th most beautiful campus in the world. And today I will be telling you a little bit about the city of Perth as a study destination. I will be talking about the courses that are available at the University of Western Australia, about applications, entry requirements. I will also mention scholarships, always an important topic, as well as talk about accommodation and the student support services, very important for international students. All right, so I guess, first of all, you need to realize that we're a long way from Latin America. But that's part of the fun. If you're going to be traveling for holiday and you don't have much time, clearly Australia is very far. But if you are going to study, you're going to be there for 6 months, 1 year, 2 year, 3 years perhaps, then don't worry about how far it is or how long it takes to get there. Just pick the destination because of the value that it will bring to you. So Perth is on the Indian Ocean. We are on the west coast of Australia. The distance between Perth and Sydney is just under 5 hours by plane. So we are a long way, but that's the great thing about it. We have wonderful climates. We have probably the best quality of life in Australia, including the best income. So people in Perth earn more money. And yet we are one of the most affordable cities. If you are an adult and you're looking to do a postgraduate course and you have a family, your children will be able to study in Perth for free. And this is not available in other cities. Then we are also one of the most livable cities. And I think the pictures I will show you next will convince you. But we are the fourth largest city in Australia. So we have 2.5 million people living in Perth. So we're not a small town. It's definitely a state capital. Importantly, because we are deemed a regional center, if you study in Australia, you can stay up to 3 or 4 years after the completion of your studies and benefit from the post-study work rights. This is very important because if you're looking to invest a lot of money and study in Australia, knowing that you can stay afterwards and earn great money is very important. So you'll get the international experience, you get to make some money, and that is very important. Now, after that, should you choose to stay in Australia, and there are about 16% of international students who end up staying in Australia. I think there will be more now, but Australia is short of people. That's a decision that is possible to make. And importantly, for international students, you will get a discount of 40% on public transport. And at the end of the year, that's worth a lot. Having said that, because Perth is a very flat city, excuse me, if you have a bicycle or a scooter or a skateboard, you can get by very easily. Okay, so Perth is a very international city. 37% of the people in Western Australia, or WA as we call it, is born overseas. Myself included, I was born in France. So there are more than 190 countries represented in Perth and 270 languages. And what we all have in common is that we are Australians and we speak English and we enjoy the lifestyle. And there are currently around 59,000 international students in Perth, not all at my university. My university has about 5,000 international students. Okay, also go back to that picture. So you can see on the top left, we have a big stadium, one of the newest stadiums in Perth. And that little animal next to that famous actor who plays Thor, that's a quokka. One thing about Australia is we have a lot of unique animals. And this little animal, the quokka, which is of the same family as the kangaroos, you will only find this animal on one little island, which is about 20 kilometers from Perth. This is where people go for a holiday. And what people try to do now, it's very popular, is to take a selfie with a quokka. Why not? Why not? So as a study destination, there's plenty to do around Perth. We're a state capital, so we've got stadiums, we've got rock bands, we've got, you know, Black Sabbath and Guns N' Roses and you know, you name it, they all come down here. We've got restaurants, clubs, but we've also got a lot of nature. Little Rottnest Island where the quokka lives. It's a marvelous place. Amazing. If you go for a swim, it's like swimming in an aquarium. Very popular, and it's fairly easy to get to from Perth. Then we also have outside of Perth, we've got Cottesloe Beach, which is really about 4 kilometers from where I'm sitting now. And this is where I go surfing in my lunch break. And then outside of Perth, we've got the Swan Valley, and then we've got Kings Park. So Kings Park on the left-hand side, that's a park which is bigger than New York Central Park. And from there, you've got the lovely view of the Central Business District, or CBD as we call it. And we also have a good view of the university campus, which is very convenient. Great thing about Western Australia is once you leave the city, there's a lot of really amazing nature, wildlife to choose and to have a look at. One of it is the Pinnacles, which is about 2 hours north of Perth. It's like Dolmen Light rock statues. And of course, as soon as you leave the city, the night sky is amazing. You will see more stars than you've ever seen anywhere else, because we have very little light interference. We have Carigini National Park, so that's a little far from downtown, but as the holidays, during the holidays, you have a lot of time to go and visit around. And this is the middle of the desert, and then you've got this wonderful oasis with water and waterfalls. It's pretty spectacular. And then south of Perth, and this is very important for the people who like wine and for the surfers, we've got Margaret River, which is where we have the World Championships surfing every year. And Valley of the Giants. So this is a very interesting thing where you've got some of the biggest trees in Australia, really, really tall trees. And they've got some bridges where you can go and walk on top of the forest. That's pretty cool. Then Ningaloo Reef, very famous for the whale sharks. Of course, they're vegetarian, so you'll get to swim with them. And then Cable Beach in Broome, quite a long way away. But, you know, students do that. Down very south of Perth, you've got Lucky Bay in Esperance. And very, very funny that kangaroos love to go to the beach, not just people. And Busselton, so this is the longest jetty in the southern hemisphere. And what's interesting is at the end of the jetty, then you've got a staircase that takes you underwater, and you can go 30 meters underwater and be in the middle of the ocean, like in a submarine. And we also have this place called the Pink Lakes, which is natural. And this is because it's very salty, so the lakes look very pink. Okay, so enough of the travel brochures. Let's focus on the university. As you can see from this picture, the campus is quite large. We have 76 hectares of land of which the university is situated. So you can see on the top that we have College Row. This is where we have all the on-campus accommodation. We also have, therefore, the health campus, the university hospital, Winthrop Hall. Then this is where you do your exams, and this is also where you get your graduation degree, so certificates at the end of it. Very famous building. It was built in 1927. We've got the E-Zone building, which is a brand new place for engineering, very modern, was only opened a couple of years ago. And then we've got the Bayliss building, which is famous for all things scientific, including genetic engineering. And then we've got the business school, which is right by the river. And the business school, very modern. It has the Equis accreditation as well as the AACSB. So those two accreditations will be on your degree. And they're the two accreditations of the top ranked business schools. Not many universities have both of them. And you can see from the main picture that we are next to this big park, King's Park, and about 5 kilometers from the central business district. So in terms of location, we are in the geographic center of Greater Perth. So if you live on campus, you really don't need to go very far, although you can, because we are very convenient. The most large universities in Australia are multidisciplinary, which means that on campus, you will have the opportunity to study a business program as well, but you can also take units in science or engineering. You can do double degrees. You can learn a language or music. All of this because everything is on campus. So this is something quite convenient. All right. So as Maria Angelica mentioned, we are part of the Group of Eight, and we're one of the top ranked universities in Australia. So we're around 90 in some of the top ones, and we are 5 stars for teaching quality. And this is year in, year out. And importantly for students, we have more than 4,500 global industry partnerships. This is very important as students have the opportunities to go on work experience and they make use of our connections in industry. Another important factor when you choose a university is we are number one in Western Australia for graduate employability. So what that means is that basically when you are looking for a work, for a job, the employers will give students from this university the jobs ahead of other universities because of our relationships with them, and because of our ranking, and because we have a great reputation among employers. So students love that. Here we go. So as I said, we are multidisciplinary, and in some subjects we are ranked in the top 50. So for example, in anatomy and physiology, we are ranked 24th in the world, in agriculture, 45th. Mineral mining engineering. So mining is very important for the state of Western Australia. We've got mining in oil and gas, in uranium and gold and lithium and cobalt and nickel and rare earth. We've got everything. So we're blessed with a lot of resources. So engineering is very important. We've got psychology, earth and marine science, very strong in geology, again, related to mining, geophysics, as well all the sports related subjects where we are ranked 22nd in the world. Right, so for example, if you focus on one area like agricultural, environmental and biological sciences, we've got more than 100 units of practical work experience for you to choose from. The students to staff ratio, which means how many students in a class, is 22 students for one teacher. So you do get a good interaction with your lecturers and teachers and tutors. We do have world experts and top academics who are ranked in the top 200. So if you're in universities, you've got some teachers who publish a lot, who do a lot of research and who are cited, that is, people use their research a lot. And we've got five lecturers who are in the top 200 of the most highly cited academics. We've also got postgraduate teaching quality above the national average, a strong industry, business and government network, as I mentioned. So all the top ones. This is very important. For example, in terms of PhDs for research degrees, the group of eight universities of which we are part of, we do 70% of the research. So it is easier to do research because we have the infrastructure, we have the support, and we also have the expertise, so we can find more places for international students. Okay, so you can see that everything from agricultural science, economics, informatics, biotechnology, geoscience, or deposit oceanography, there's a lot of areas that students can choose from. Next, business and law. So as I mentioned before, the two accreditation of AACSB and EQUIS. Excuse me. Then we also have the trading room. So we're very lucky that we were given money to set up a trading room like the stock exchange. So instead of having to learn about how to buy and sell shares on the ASX, the stock exchange, we have a live one with 80 terminals where we are live on the share market. So students learn in real time how to buy and sell shares, a very popular learning program. And of course, you don't want to send, because otherwise you'd have to buy all the shares that you're looking to buy. In the business school, so both we have a bachelor, master's and PhDs in all the areas, including applied finance. We've got the MBAs, commerce, electronics, human resources, public policy, accounting and so forth. So lots of areas that you can do that. All our courses are internationally accredited. So for example, if you do an accounting program, you will get the accreditation of accounting that will allow you to work as an accountant. We've got exceptional MBA programs as well, because we are top ranked, and students get to do some amazing work with the MBA. Now, a word of caution, for the MBA, you need to have 3 or 4 years experience at the professional level. So for the MBA, we are looking for people who finish university, who have got onto work, who have maybe 5 to 10 years experience at management level. If you are interested in doing an MBA but do not have that level of professional experience, what we recommend is for students to do the Master of Commerce. It is the same course, except that it is taught differently from the MBA. So happy to talk to you some more about that if you're looking into that course at the Q&A at the end of it. Now, a big area also is physical sciences and engineering. So, as I said, we've got this new 80 million e-zone building, which is just transforming the way we teach. We've got the Master of Professional Engineering, which includes 8 specializations. So we got civil, mechanical, and so forth, all of them. And I'll talk a bit more about that next. So we've got a very interesting course in ocean leadership, renewal, future energy, data science, IT, biotechnology, geoscience, hydrogeology, oceanography, ore deposit geology, petroleum geoscience, and physics as well. So a lot to choose from. Okay, so research degrees. In Australia, research degrees are typically 4 years in duration. Unlike the US, where a teaching the PhD is mostly a teaching degree, where you do mostly teaching and a little bit of research, we do our PhD the same way they do in the UK, which is 4 years of pure research. We also have the Master by Research, which is 2 years. The difference between the master's and the PhD is that the PhD, you are expected to advance scholarship. You need to discover something new. And I can tell you about how to prepare for a PhD. So a PhD means that at the end of it, you'll be the world expert on your subject. And that's very exciting. The average is 4 years. Some people take 6 years. It depends on the subject. Some people take less, but the average is 4 years. The advantage of a PhD or a Master by Research is there are no deadlines. You can start anytime throughout the year. We've tried to streamline the application process to save you time and finding you a supervisor. And then we also have, if you get into a PhD program, you get a 10-week English language program to improve your English if that's what you need. And I'll talk a bit more about the English program next. Okay, so we have a language center, which is where I am calling you from. We welcome a lot of students who want to improve their English. So we have two types of students. Some students need to improve the English ahead of a course, bachelor, master, or PhD. But we also have a number of students who don't want to do a degree program. They just want to do an English language course and just improve their English. And of the three students on the picture, the two on the left are both Colombian, which is interesting, but they went on to do a degree. If you want to do a degree program, we need to know your level of English. If you have to do an exam like the IELTS or TOEFL, and if you get 6.5 IELTS of the academic program, that means your English is at the right level and you do not need to do an English course. If you have a lower score, for example, if you look at the top line, if you've done the IELTS exams and you've got 5.5 result with no band below zero, then we would recommend that you do a 20-week bridging course. If you already have an IELTS of 6, then we would recommend a 10-week or 3 months bridging course. If you have a lower than that, then we would get you maybe 8 months, 10 months, 1 year of English course. It all depends on the level of English. So that's very important. So if you are looking to do an English course ahead of a degree, this is what we call a package of English and degree. You would apply for one visa and you'd have a visa for the entire duration of your program. If you just want to do an English course, you don't need to have any particular level. We will get you to do an online test. It's free, and it will help us to determine your level of English so we can find a class for your level that's appropriate for you. But we can talk some more about that if you have any questions. Okay, so if a student is interested in applying, you can apply pretty much anytime. Applications for most courses open 2 years prior to the start date. So it's fairly straightforward. What do we need? If you want to do an English course and only an English course, we don't need anything. If you are looking for a degree program, we will need a copy of your passport, a transcript of your results, be it high school or university, a result of your English language level, say an IELTS or a TOEFL exams, and any other supporting documents, for example, work references if you're looking for an MBA. So Latino Education Australia, LAE, will be helping you with getting all those students translated in English as well, I am sure. So that's fairly straightforward. What we have also organized is we have Global Excellence Scholarships. So the GES, as the name implies, is based on excellence. And this is both for undergraduate and for postgraduate. So what we look at is we look at your grades from high school or from your bachelor. The higher the grade, the bigger the scholarship. So for example, students who have got very high international baccalaureate or US SATs or things like that, then they can get up to $12,000 per year. And if it's a 3-year bachelor, that will be worth $36,000. If you've got lower results, then you can get $10,000 or $6,000. So that's very important. And this is not limited to just a few courses. This is for most courses. Only excluded are medicine and law. Otherwise, you can get those scholarships. For postgraduate, again, you can see from Argentina or Chile or Colombia, if you've got a 5 from Colombia, which is a very high GPA, then you can get $12,000 per year. And if it's 3.67, you are still eligible for a $6,000 scholarship. So that's very important. And you do not have to do anything. You don't need to apply for this scholarship separately. You will automatically be awarded it as you apply, and because you would also be giving us your results. So as we look at your results, we look for your eligibility into the course and then also include the eligibility for the scholarship. Then you would get an offer letter where the payment, the fee, will be reduced by the amount from the scholarship. Okay. In addition, we also have some discount agreement with the various scholarship bodies in around the LATAM region and in Colombia. With through Cool Futuro, you will get a 25% discount and for the masters and 35% for the PhDs. So hopefully that will bring a smile to everybody. All right. Then for the English programs, we have a special price for Latin America, LATAM, which is $330 per week. And normally it's $410. And for the scholarship conditions, it's valid for language and communication essentials. So it's one of the programs we have for EAP. And then it's valid from term 9 from this month. Okay, so from September. It's only for international students. And it's also valid for standalone English. So even if you just want to do an English course, Latino Education Australia will be able to provide you with those fees. Right. So as I said, that the advantage of choosing to study in Western Australia is you are entitled to the post-study work visa. That means that on the completion of your studies in Australia, you apply for the post-study work visa and you can stay longer. So if you do a bachelor degree, you will get a 3-year visa. If you do a master's degree, it will be a 4-year visa. And if you do a PhD, up to 5 years. So if you do a 4-year PhD plus a 5-year, you'll be in Australia for 9 years. That will be an important change in your life. If you bring a dependent, for example, if you're married, your wife can come and she can work full time. Or he, if it's your husband, he can work full time. The minimum wage in Australia is 20.33 an hour plus 25% a loading. So in Australia, it is very common for students to work. You can work from the age of 14. I've got 3 children, 14, 18, and 19, and they're all working. My daughter, who is at university in second year, she's got a part-time job and she makes $29 an hour. And she works in a supermarket. So very simple, straightforward jobs. My boy is already on $20 an hour because he's younger, age 20. On Sundays, it's also $30 an hour. So as you consider Australia, you will find that, yes, it is expensive. The fees that we quote are high, However, the cost of living in Australia is commensurate with the wages, so you will earn good money, and that is important to consider as you plan your trip. Okay, now during your studies, you are allowed to work 20 hours a week or 40 hours a fortnight. However, during the holidays, you can work full time. You're not limited to 20 hours per week. So the university in Australia, the universities have two intakes. Semester one begins in February, around the middle of February, and goes on until the middle of June. Semester two starts middle of July and finishes middle of September. So you can see that at the end of the semester two, middle of November until middle of February, you've got a lot of time to work and make some money, or travel, visit, or maybe even go back to your family if that's what you wish. Okay, a little word about accommodation. So the university has got residential colleges. We've got five colleges: St. Catherine, St. George's College, St. Thomas More, Trinity Residential College, as well as University Hall. So this is the weekly fee, $370 at University Hall, up to $485 St. Catherine College, which takes you around to between just under $15,000 all the way to just under $20,000 per year. Again, that seems a lot of money. However, you are on campus. So if you leave on campus accommodation, there is no waste of time to travel, no waste of time to commute, and no transport costs. And everything is included: electricity, water, Wi-Fi, and food, three meals a day. So this is actually quite good. And if I say to you that you're then going to work $25 an hour for 20 hours, you can fund the cost of living on campus. Now, you can find cheap accommodation, especially if you share a house, but then you've got to pay the electricity and travel and commute. So it's something that you can work out. Right now, the accommodation on campus is in demand. So you need to put your name down as soon as you decide that you want to come to UWA and apply. As soon as you apply for a course, if you want to stay on campus accommodation, please apply as well. It's very important. There is a lot of demand from international students and local students since the COVID. A lot of people went back to Australia. So there's high demand for accommodation. One way we can find accommodation for you, especially at the beginning, it would be a homestay family, where we can still find accommodation with a homestay family, which is very useful at the beginning. And you can stay with the homestay family anytime from 1 to 6 months to 2 years. And then it gives you time to look for something other than that. So we don't have the problems like they have in Sydney and Melbourne, where accommodation is really expensive and complicated to find. But there is some pressure in Perth as well. Okay, so off-campus accommodation. So there are some campus. One is Campus Perth and the other one is a student housing company. These are buildings downtown in the central business district where you can find accommodation. This is not owned by the university. This is private accommodation. And this is only for international students. Campus Perth, for example, they've got some rooms where you can share with other students. And that's $145 per week. And they're bunk beds. There's studio apartments with double beds, and there's other areas as well, up to 6 students per room as well. Again, that is also something that you would need to contact them fairly quickly to secure a place. Okay. Very important is that once you arrive in Perth and you become a student with us, there will be a lot of support as students. So you will have, for example, one-to-one study advice. There will be an academic skills advisor online to improve your writing, study maths, stats, statistics, and English language. So this is when you've met all the entry requirements, we're still not forgetting about you, we will help you along. We also have special workshops that you can join to develop your writing, research, English language, and presentation skills, as well as maths and statistics as well. And then we also have after hours study help. So you won't be alone. So this is very important, especially in the first semester of your studying with us, because you would expect that we do things maybe differently in Australia compared to your country. Not better, but different. So the first 6 months, we find that it is important to provide support so that you can easily fit in and blend without too much stress. So as I said before, because you'll be able to stay up to 5 years afterwards, it is very important for you to find support for how to find a job when you finish your studies. And at UWA, we have a career center, which is a dedicated office to help students develop their employability skills. You will also have a career mentor link, and he will help you match your professional ambitions with your interests. And then we also have work integrated learning, which is a unit where you will get credits for a unit through a placement, an internship or industry project. So while you are a student, you can go, for example, and work or do a research for a company, and you will get credits as part of your course. And this is where a lot of students find future employment, by doing one of those placements. This is not additionally complicated, and this is very popular with students and industry partners. All right, now, as well as studying, as well as support, you will find that there's a lot of things you can do. We have more than 150 clubs and societies on campus. Sporting clubs, you know, judo, basketball, Australian rules football, cricket, soccer, you name it, 150 clubs, karate, taekwondo, yoga, pilates, squash, tennis. But we also have other clubs, which are political clubs. There's religious clubs, if that's what you like. There's all kinds of clubs for you to choose from. And a great way to meet Australians and engage with Australian society. So being in the big campus, plenty for you to do and make new friends. And perhaps one of the things to mention is that we have a uni buddy system. So while you are still in LATAM and you are interested into a course, and if you would like to talk to a student at UWA who is currently studying the course that you are interested in and you want to ask questions, then get online to our uni buddy. You can see the website at the bottom, uwaedu.au, study international students. Chat to a student, and you can get in touch with a student and ask the questions like, you know, how many hours a week of homework do you do? Are there pretty girls on campus? Are the boys very friendly? How easy is it to find a job? Get this information, not just from me or from Maria Angelica, but from a student who is currently studying, and you'll find that's very useful and it's very popular. And if once you are in Perth, if you want to nominate to become a uni buddy for future students, you will get remunerated. So one way to get in with the program. Uni buddy, very popular with students. Okay. And you may be interested to know that there is a Latino community in Perth. And there's the Latino Festival. And there's lots of clubs if you want to meet them, and you can find all the foods that you're used to. They'll tell you how to find it as well. So HUG, Hispanic University Group, who'd have thought? Okay, and we invite you to contact us through our Facebook page. We got America Latin at UWA, University WA, we've got Snapchats, we've got UWA Blues, we got lots of advisory support, and of course you can contact us. So my name is Olivier, although everybody calls me Ollie, and then there's Ruth, my colleague, and we're very happy to help you out if you have any questions. So yeah, that's me for my presentation, and
okay, Olivia, thank you so much for your time. Muchísimas gracias de verdad a todos por estar conectados. It was a valuable presentation. Thank you so much for all the information you provide us. And now is the time that we can resolve all the questions that maybe all the people had. Muchísimas gracias a todos de nuevo. De verdad que pues fue súper valiosa toda la información que Olivia nos compartió. Por favor, si tienen dudas, comentarios adicionales, por favor no duden en dejárnoslas aquí por el chat. Olivia nos compartió su email de contacto. De igual manera, recuerden que nos pueden contactar a la agencia, nosotros al LAE como tal, hola@lae-edu.com, para resolver todas las dudas adicionales que puedan llegar a tener. Aquí teníamos una pregunta que nos hicieron Jane Server Valencia respecto de las oportunidades de las prácticas profesionales que la universidad efectivamente ofrece. Creo que esa pregunta igual la hicieron antes de que Olivia pues hablara como precisamente de que la universidad tiene un Career Center, un centro pues enfocado como en brindar toda la asesoría o toda la información a los estudiantes que ya están en la universidad directamente. Y de manera tal que puedan, por supuesto, encontrar un empleo. Por otra parte, también otra de las herramientas que me gustó muchísimo es que tú puedes chatear con un estudiante que está viviendo la misma experiencia. Qué mejor que eso, que te lo cuente una persona pues, que está viviendo la experiencia, que tú puedas resolver como todas las preguntas que tú puedas llegar a tener. Así que bueno, pueden también ingresar a la página web para que puedan tener información y resolver cualquier otra duda de alguien que en realidad está viviendo como en primera persona la experiencia que tú vivirás en un futuro. Por favor, no olviden dejarnos por aquí todas sus preguntas. Voy a empezar por aquí con una de Gustavo. Dice, me interesa tener claro el sistema de pago de la maestría. ¿Se debe pagar el curso completo o pagar por semestre? Olivia, the question is from Gustavo. He says, I would like to have the information regarding to the payment plan of the master. Should I pay the full master or can I pay by semester?
So yes, good question. You can pay by semester. We don't expect full payment upfront, only one semester. So typically a degree will be about $42,000 per year. So you'll be paying about $20,000 or less if you have a scholarship. So if you've got $20,000 and you got a full scholarship, then you will get $6,000 off. So it will be $14,000 per semester.
Ok, thank you so much. Bueno, Gustavo, básicamente sí, efectivamente el pago lo puedes hacer por semestre, ¿listo? Entonces, desde tu país de origen, desde donde nos estés escribiendo, Gustavo, antes de aplicar a la visa debes hacer el pago del primer semestre y estando en Australia, pues continúas haciendo los siguientes pagos. Lo que Olivia nos decía era que los programas están alrededor de los 40, 42 mil dólares australianos por año, sin embargo, pues tú pagas el valor del semestre, pero si eres elegible para una beca, que Olivia nos las mostró ahí, ahí podríamos ver las calificaciones o el promedio mínimo que debe tener una persona por país, en Colombia, en México, en Perú. Entonces, si eres elegible para una beca, sería deducir el monto de beca que te haya sido otorgado por la universidad. ¿Listo? Tenemos otra pregunta de Luis. Hola, si voy a estudiar un MBA y estando en Australia consigo una oferta laboral de tiempo completo de alguna empresa, ¿mi visa puede modificarse a una visa de trabajo sin mucho problema o no se permite esto? Olivia, the question that we have from Luis is, hi, if I study an MBA program and being in Australia, I get an offer letter, a full-time job offer, so sorry, from any company, my student visa could be modified for a sponsor or work visa without any problem, or that is not possible?
So it is possible. So I would expect that the job offer would probably come at the end of your student visa. But even if it was through the middle, because somebody really wants to give you a job, so it would be up to the company that wants to sponsor you to provide all the documents and apply for your visa, sponsored visa. How easy or how hard, I can't tell. Ultimately, the decision to grant a visa, be it a student visa or a PR visa, resident visa, work visa, that is done by the Department of Home Affairs. It is very common. I mean, even my university, we employ a lot of people from around the world, and the government is very reasonable. So if you have a skill that a company needs and they want to sponsor you, I think that's very common.
Exacto, Luis. Bueno, lo que sucede es que cuando tú viajas a una maestría, aplicarías en principio a una visa de estudiante, una student visa. Entonces la idea, por supuesto, es que digamos que esa oferta laboral pueda llegar una vez tú finalices el master degree, cuando termines la maestría. Además, por lo que nos ha explicado Olivia, que después de los 2 años de la maestría, pues vas a poder estar en Perth años adicionales trabajando hasta tiempo completo. Les mostraba el ejemplo de, bueno, por ejemplo, si haces un doctorado, podrías estar hasta 9 años en Australia. Sin embargo, si alguien, una empresa decide, ese término se conoce como sponsor, alguna empresa decide patrocinarte, por supuesto que es posible. Sin embargo, ellos deben de encargarse de hacer el cambio de la visa. Y lo que nos decía Olivia es que este tema compete pues al departamento de Home Affairs, que es el departamento pues que se encarga de todo el tema de visas para personas que no son australianas. Listo, tenemos otra pregunta de Paola Delgadillo, es administradora ambiental y quiere especializarse o tener un título en investigación en ciencias de agricultura, agriculturales o agronomía. Realmente está pues muy interesada como en el tema de la investigación relacionada con nutrición o alimentación. Así que ella quería saber si hay alguna posibilidad de obtener un degree, un programa, un título como estos en la Universidad de Western Australia.
So I saw the question from Paola. So the answer is yes. So the university is doing a lot of research through the Future Farm. For how the question we are looking to answer is, how are we going to feed the world in 50 years' time? So the Future Farm, which is over 4,000 acres, about 4 hours north of Perth, and we are looking to see how we can improve animal feeding, how we can improve production, and how we can sustain the environment, given that we have global warming, we got poor soil, and we've got salination coming through. So all this research we do is from many angles. So yes, we would be able to help you with that. I'll just give you one example. For example, that we're looking at is, when you grow a tomato plant, a lot of the energy goes to grow the plant, and only 20% goes to grow the fruit. By doing some genetic manipulation, we can switch that the plant will grow more fruit and less plant. So that's how we can improve on it. Another one is we found that the problem with growing cattle is they produce a lot of methane gases. Yet by changing the feed, by giving them something other than grass, we found that we can reduce the methane. So that's something that's very important. And we do a lot of that research. So you'd be most welcome to join us and help out.
Listo, muchísimas gracias. Thank you so much, Olivia, for your answer. Tenemos otra pregunta de Oscar Zapata. Dice, buenas noches, respecto al programa de posgrado de medicina, ¿cuánto tiempo previo hay que aplicar y cuál es el costo, por favor? The question from Oscar Zapata is, regarding to the medicine program, how much time should it apply before the start date and how much is the cost, please?
Okay, so at the University of Western Australia, our medicine course is a postgraduate course, so it's an MD. So the total length of the program is a 3-year bachelor followed by a 3-year doctor of medicine. You can come with us to do all courses, bachelor and doctor, or you can do your a bachelor in Colombia and then come and do a graduate entry. That depends on where you are at with your studies. It's very competitive. We have about 20 places and about 600 applicants every year. Before you apply, you need to do a general medical admissions test, the GMAT test, which you have to submit before May of each year. So right now for next February, it is too late. You can only start now to look for 2024. And in 2023, before the end of May, you will have to done those tests as well. So there's, first of all, those medical admissions tests, then they would, if you are selected in the top 60, then there will be a structured interview, and then you can get in there as well. So it's very expensive as well. So the 3 years of the Doctor of Medicine is $75,000 per year. And for this course, there are unfortunately no scholarships.
Vale, muchísimas gracias, Olivia. Bueno, no sé si alguien más tenga otra pregunta que nos quiera compartir. Recuerden que desde la AE estaremos más que felices de ayudarlos con todo su proceso de aplicación. a la universidad. Nosotros les ayudaríamos, por supuesto, a revisar los documentos, a hacer la aplicación. Una vez tengan, enviamos los documentos para la universidad, pues podrían tener su carta de oferta, que por ejemplo, en el caso de Colfuturo, estudiantes que se encuentren en Colombia, ya van a cumplir con ese requisito para la convocatoria que abre el próximo año. De igual manera, la beca que está disponible, que tiene disponible, el gobierno de Perú, también requiere carta de oferta. Entonces, bueno, nosotros les ayudamos con todo ese proceso. Tenemos otra pregunta por aquí de Jaf Fonseca, 1177, que dice que para ingenieros industriales, ¿cuál es la maestría que ofreces en la que tiene la universidad disponible?
So for industrial engineering, so we do not have a course called industrial engineering, but we do have civil and mechanical engineering as well. And I guess you could even include data science and IT as part of the industrial engineering. So we have a number of courses that you'd be invited to look at. Certainly look on our website, uwa.edu.au, or even just to do and then or just put UWA engineering, and that will take you straight to the specializations. And then once you're into the website, you can actually look above the course and you can look at the units that they teach, and then that would work well. And then please go and have a look at our UniBuddy and get in touch with somebody or even somebody at the faculty to see what you want to learn, what you want to get out of your course, to see that we would whether we would be the right institution for your plans.
Exactamente. Thank you so much, Olivia. Muchas gracias por tu respuesta. Bueno, si alguien tiene alguna otra duda en lo que les podamos ayudar respecto de la universidad, de las becas, de la duración de los programas, el proceso de visado, por favor, adelante. Tenemos una pregunta de Virginia. Si se viaja con familia, puede ser si se es madre soltera o necesariamente tiene que estar la pareja. If I travel with family and I am a single mother, should I travel by myself or should I travel with my couple, with my partner? Well, I would like to answer this question, Olivia. En este caso, Virginia, tú puedes aplicar a tu visa. Es decir, relacionando obviamente a tu familia, en este caso pues a tu hijo o a tu hija, o si tienes pues varios hijos, lo relacionamos en tu formulario de aplicación y puedes viajar sola. Que es súper importante al momento de tener de poder viajar, incluso eso es si te encuentras por ejemplo en Chile o en cualquier país, para poder salir del aeropuerto de tu país de origen, debes de tener o todos los derechos sobre el menor, o la representación para que pueda viajar contigo, o debe de tener un poder por escrito, así se le conoce en algunos países como poder, documento notariado o una autorización notariada que certifique de que efectivamente tú puedes viajar con el menor al extranjero. ¿Listo? Eso también se adjunta en el formulario de aplicación, ese documento. Y no es necesario entonces viajar con pareja, simplemente así que tengas en cuenta como esos documentos que se deben de demostrar. Tenemos otra pregunta de Gustavo, por favor, ¿puedes dar más detalles del paquete que incluye el curso de inglés y del máster? Could you please give me more details about what is included in the package English plus master?
Sure, sure. So what we will try to do is make sure that we can help improve your English so that when you do your master's, given that everything will be in English, you will be expected to join in group work with Australian students. We want to make sure that you are ready for the demands of the course in English. So the English program will be teaching you, obviously, the language, the grammar, the vocabulary, but also it will be a preparation for university studies expectation. So for example, typically a student will be able to work in group works, make presentations, and that can be quite stressful when you're not a native speaker. So this is where in the language program, we will train you for that and you'll get the practice and so that you'll be ready. Bear in mind that once you have finished the English language program, you will not be perfect, but you will have enough to continue to improve so that at the end of your master's, then you can be perfect.
Thank you so much. We have another question here. Etienne, en base a su experiencia con los estudiantes, ¿cuál es el proceso más cómodo para financiar la maestría? ¿Los estudiantes ya cuentan con los 42 mil dólares australianos por año o esperan trabajar en Australia mientras estudian para financiar la carrera? Muchas gracias. We have another question here, Etienne. Regarding to your experience with international students, what is the most accessible or the most the best way to finance the master? Most of the students have the 42,000 Australian dollars per year, or should they wait to work in Australia while they are working to finance the master degree? Thank you so much.
So I think that working in Australia will allow you to fund the cost of living. So if you look at your budget, you've got transport, tuition fees, cost of living. Working in Australia while you study, you can help with the cost of living. However, you need to have the tuition fees taken care of, either through a bank loan, either through family connections, or through called Futuro and so forth. You will not be able to earn everything. Once you have finished your studies and then you work full-time in your profession, say as an engineer or a data scientist, then you will have extra money, then you can repay the bank loan, but you cannot do everything working 20 hours per week.
Thank you so much, Olivier. Exacto, Tien. De igual manera, recordemos que para aplicar a la visa nosotros debemos de demostrarle al gobierno australiano, mira, efectivamente yo cuento con los recursos para mi manutención, por una parte, que es alojamiento, transporte, alimentación, y por otra parte, cuento con los recursos para pagar mi primer año de estudios. Entonces, lo que nos decía Olivier, súper válido tener en cuenta este punto. Entonces, si voy a financiar, por ejemplo, a través de un crédito beca, que tiene mi país, por ejemplo, FIDER, COFUTURO, bueno, cualquiera de las opciones de beca que tienen cada uno de los gobiernos de Latinoamérica, bueno, tener ese punto. En caso tal de que no, bueno, voy a entonces a aplicar a una de las becas si soy elegible a una de las becas que ofrece la universidad, y en caso tal de que esa beca, por ejemplo, sea parcial, revisar la opción con una entidad financiera de mi país. Por ejemplo, en Ecuador, muchos estudiantes financian con Banco Pichincha. En el Perú, muchos estudiantes financian con el BCP. Entonces, es muy importante como, bueno, poder tener estos puntos claros para sí mismo saber cómo vamos a financiar el primer año de estudio. Ya que lo que decía Olivia, mientras tú estás trabajando, puedes ayudarte con los gastos, digamos, de lo que es la experiencia como tal, transporte, alimentación y demás. Pero sí debemos de, desde nuestros países, viajar con estos puntos ya claros. Tenemos otra pregunta por aquí. Bueno, ya no la vieron en inglés. Y dice, estoy interesada en estudiar arquitectura en Australia, pero necesito trabajar en mi inglés. ¿Tienes algún curso que yo pueda tomar y aumentar mis habilidades y conectar después con el programa de la universidad? ¿Cuántas semanas estos cursos tienen? Muchas gracias. You can go ahead.
I can. So great course. So in Australia, in my university, architecture is a 5-year program. And yes, we can certainly package an English and architecture course. The question that you ask is, how long will your course of English will be? And the answer is, it depends on your level. So if you are close to the 6.5 IELTS, maybe you only need 1 month of English, or maybe 3 months. So we will test you, we will find out your level of English, and then we have a bar to determine how many weeks of English you need. If you are familiar with the IELTS test program, the numbers or the results are in half points. So you can have 4, 4.5, 5, 5.5, and so forth. You need 6.5. If you only have 6, to go up by 0.5, generally it's a 3 months period. So if you get an IELTS of 5, you need 6.5, it will be 3 times 10 weeks, 30 weeks, and so on and so forth.
Exactamente. Entonces, eso va a depender del nivel de inglés básicamente que tengan cada uno de ustedes. Sabemos que algunas personas en Latinoamérica, bueno, tienen un muy buen nivel de inglés, han estudiado inglés, pero hay otras que sí les falta un poquito. Entonces, la cantidad de tiempo que tú vas a necesitar estudiar para ingresar previamente al programa, pues va a depender de tu examen de inglés. En caso tal de que hayas tomado un IELTS, podemos revisar eso, el resultado de tu último IELTS, por ejemplo, si es que lo has tomado, y hacerte como una recomendación para que sepas con cuánto tiempo de inglés deberías estudiar. Tenemos otra pregunta por aquí. Oscar Zapata, soy estudiante de medicina. ¿Se puede hacer internado médico allá? ¿Y con qué red de hospitales trabajaban, por favor? We have a question from Oscar Zapata. I am a medicine student. Can I make an internship, medicine internship there? And which hospitals network do you work, please?
Good question. I'm not quite sure. I know that Australia is short of doctors and they're looking to bring some doctors, but medicine is quite protected in the sense that before you can do an internship or before you can do, you can talk to a patient or touch a patient, you need to satisfy the Royal Australasian College of Doctors and Surgeons that A, your training is the same as Australia. Two, that your level of English is really high, and three, that you're a safe person in terms of, no criminal activity and so forth. So this is not something I have much information on. I would think that once you have finished your studies and once you've got some experience, then coming to work in Australia would be possible, but there would be some exams to proceed. One of them would be an English exam, and the other another one would be an English exam focusing on medical terms, and then there would also be a practical a practice. So I know that in the past we had international students coming to the language center to improve their English and then sitting those exams. And I remember talking to a student from Iran actually. And she passed those exams, and she was telling me that they had to sit down in front of a panel of doctors in a room, and all of them would say, okay, somebody comes along, is a 25-year-old female, she's presenting with these symptoms, what would you do? And she had to answer the questions about how she would proceed. So that's part of the question. Sorry, it's a long answer to your questions. It is possible, but not necessarily as an internship while you study, more likely at the end of your studies.
Exacto, thank you so much, Olivia, for your answer. Exactamente, el tema médico sí es algo que regula mucho en Australia, precisamente para validar que efectivamente pues tienes como todas las habilidades y el dominio del idioma, que lo que nos decía Olivia, tiene un nivel bastante alto de inglés para poder que puedas, digamos, recibir consultas o atender pacientes en Australia. Así que es un proceso bastante largo para poder tener finalmente o poder acceder a recibir pacientes, atender pacientes. Tenemos otra pregunta por aquí de Joy from Magariño López. Es de El Salvador y quiere hacer un pregrado, una carrera universitaria relacionada con biomedicina. Si tenemos algún, que si la universidad tiene algún curso como eso, y si puede empezar sus clases online este año y luego llegar al campus en el 2023.
Okay, good question. So yes, we do have biomedical science. We have it either through the science faculty, and we also have biomedical engineering, which is very popular as well. As you know, nowadays medicine and engineering are very closely linked with all the computers, remote operations, and so forth. So yes, you can do that as well. So we have already started semester two, which started middle of July. So for 2022, you cannot start online. 2023, definitely but you still have enough time to get set up to start your course in 2023. Some courses you can do online, but not all units. So, for example, in science and engineering, there are some labs where you need to be there. So, what students who've not been able to get there quickly online, they were doing some core units, but not the labs, which they will catch up when they are able to travel.
Exactamente, hay algunas cosas, Jeffrey, que tienes que hacerlas de manera presencial, tienes que asistir directamente a la universidad, así que algunas materias sí las podrías cursar online sin problema. Sin embargo, otras sí tienes que ir pues a la universidad presencialmente, lo que nos explicaba Olivia, pues, específicamente temas de laboratorios. Entonces, las prácticas de laboratorio. Así que, bueno, pues te invitamos de igual manera que te pongas en contacto con nosotros. Recuerden que pueden escribirnos al correo hola @lae_edu.com nos dejan saber un poco acerca de su perfil. ¿Quiénes son ustedes? ¿Cuántos años tienen? ¿Qué estudiaron en su país? ¿A qué se dedican actualmente? Y ahorita, pues que vimos como toda la información con el IBI en esta presentación, de igual manera pueden revisar el sitio web de la universidad directamente para que vean, bueno, qué opciones de posgrados, qué maestrías o research, los temas de investigación que tiene la universidad. Nos dejen saber entonces en qué programas están interesados y también si es a nivel de bachelor, que son las carreras universitarias, a nivel de maestrías o a nivel de doctorados. Nos cuenten un poquito de cuáles son sus planes de viaje. ¿Planean viajar con familia, con pareja, tienen hijos, van a viajar solos? Si de pronto quizá aplicaron a una beca, no sé, en el caso de Chile, por ejemplo, las becas ANID, si ya se las adjudicaron o si planean o tienen en mente postular alguna beca, nos dejan saber, por favor, también. Si ya tomaron una prueba de inglés, IELTS, TOEFL, PTE, alguna prueba internacional para medir esta competencia. Y bueno, entre más detalles nos puedan dejar en el correo, muchísimo mejor para nosotros para responderles de la mejor manera, de la manera más pronta y poderles orientar, pues por supuesto, de acuerdo con sus intereses. Bueno, vemos que no hay más preguntas. Muchísimas gracias de verdad a todos por conectarse. Thank you so much, Olivia, for all the information you provide us. It was really grateful to have you here tonight. Well, this morning you in Perth. And thank you so much for all the information. We don't have any questions so far. So I really appreciate your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Maria Angelica, for your help and support. And thank you to all the students for joining in. I really appreciate it and I look forward to seeing you in Perth.
Okay, bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
I'm Mez. I'm an international student from Malaysia. I'm currently doing a Bachelor of Science, majoring in genetics, microbiology, and immunology. Currently doing my honors. Student life here is really great. Because it's also an international place, there's so many other people from all over the world that come here and you learn their culture, what they do, where they come from. It broadens your mind. Day-to-day life, you would wake up, go for breakfast, hang out with friends, talk to friends, and go to uni, go for lectures, get a bit of studying done through the day. At night, go for dinner, maybe your friends want to hang out, go to the beach during the afternoons on weekends. Uni hall has changed me a lot. I have learned so much in the past 3.5 years than I have probably my entire life, and it really has developed me into the person I am today.
Hi, I'm Ellen. I'm an international student from Thailand. I'm currently studying Doctor of Medicine here at UWA. So Perth is located on the western coast of Australia. It's about 5-hour flight from Singapore, and it's really close to all other parts of Asia. People here are so warm and so friendly. I think I'm really lucky to have met friends and colleagues in the course who are so supportive. Can't put into words that how vibrant a college life is. It's the cultural diversity. It's really the people you meet and the things you do. They give me memories that I will treasure for the rest of my life.
My name is Yasmin. I'm a third year exchange student from the University of Exeter in the UK. Back at home, I study psychology and drama, but out here, I'm studying social sciences. For me, one of the best experiences about being a student here is living in a residential college. And the best thing about that is kind of being in close proximity with people of different ages, backgrounds, cultures, ways of life. There's always something going on, and it makes the student experience really enriching. In terms of lifestyle, I found out that Perth had the lifestyle that I wanted, which is a very laid back, you know, I get to go to the beach after classes, and that's exactly what I wanted. And then I fell in love with the campus and the idea of the greenery and being right next to the river and the CBD at the same time as well.
I have a wider view of things rather than having a narrow vision of situations. I encompass the whole thing and I take into account everything. That's something that coming to college has really taught me to do.
I'm really happy and it's such a beautiful city with a lot of the people who are really, really kind. And then all the support and help I get throughout these years has really made me feel like I'm so lucky to have found this place as my home.